Alright, everyone.
It's the next morning. It's going to be a beautiful day once again. About to go pull the anchor. Keep motoring out to the spot we need to fish.
Talk about half an hour.
Well, we'll have to pull the anchor.
Alright, everyone.
So, last day of fishing. About to throw our couple of sets in. We're just doing a half day today. Gonna run back up the line after we haul them this afternoon. And yeah, hopefully catch a few more fish here. Kinda hit our goal for this trip. So, pretty happy about that. We're just getting these hooks used up and catching a few more pounds. So, yeah, we'll set her out here and hopefully catch a few more fish.
Just pulling up on our first set for the day. Only got two short ones out today. Last day of fishing, we're headed home this afternoon. So this is just a little four shot one. A little over 0.4 mile.
Put it in the squeaky way. Oh wait.
No, never mind.
Huh. Just the way it's been. give a little dose of little WD-40. Oh, we're already up.
Somebody's there.
Feels some tugging to you?
A little tugging.
All right. Big tug.
Gravel bottom.
Feels a little tug in there.
Thank you. shallow. Rocking stuff. Pretty sure that broke out. Annoying.
Boulders down there, guys.
This one got us worried.
We'll have to remember this.
Yeah, so if we were hauling off the stern, there's no way that we would have been able to turn on that.
Yeah, we got close.
I felt it just get tight. Got tight for a sec, I could feel it slip in the crack, and then it just kind of immediately went slack, so probably a good sign. Certain we would have lost the set if we were pulling off the turn.
Yeah, already a couple of good snags.
Yeah.
Thank you.
some of the tastiest seafood in Alaska.
One of our favorites. You get to go back today.
Hey, buddy. So these guys are usually slow when you pull them up with longline gear because it takes a while to get them up to the surface so their air bladders have time to equalize. Kind of like if they're just swimming to the surface, chasing a school of fish or something, which they do. And we're pulling them with jig gear, they have a lower survival rate. Wondering, this is my steering right here. This is the throttle. A lot of times we just kind of idle along. And I'll just put it in the direction that it needs to go. It's called a follow-up steering lever, which means it doesn't self-center itself every time you let go. The rudder stays in the position of this lever. So right now we're pointed to starboard. When you're turning, you want to center back up again, or you'll just kind of continue going in an arc, even after the boat's out of gear. That's a 25 mark right there. We have all our line marks so we know kind of where we're at. Mark it at 25 fathoms, 55 fathoms, and 75 fathoms. The red mark in the middle and yellow at the 25 and 75. That just kind of makes it nice to let you know where you're at of the shot. thinking this might be the last one.
Yeah, I think so.
Alright. Yeah, so should be getting pretty close here. I think the next one is the one that broke off. Dropping that arm down to lower our center of gravity. Boy, this is really snaggy now.
It sure is.
It wasn't just the part that broke that was stuck in the crack. It was a
few parts.
A section of it.
Yeah.
I found the mark right where she broke off. Yeah!
That's it.
We win!
Nice. No gear loss. A few hooks destroyed, but yeah, there are the hooks in the line.
Yep. We'll just splice this thing back together, just like new.
Yeah. Some minor chafage on, but
probably not even enough to cut out, really.
No, not really.
All right, guys, well, that's it.
Recovered our gear.
We're done, we're headed home.
Yeah.
So it looks like this trip ends on a good note. Some beautiful fish on that set. Yeah, got everything back, I'm happy.
Yeah, me too. It's so fun fishing those big fish, but gold dang, that was a snaggy set right there.
It sure was, yeah. One last night was kind of snaggy, but nothing like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think, like you said, those big boulders in there, like, must be really rocky under the water.
Yeah, and it's always worse when you break off right at the beginning of a set, too, because then you got all the way to get back to it, and you're just, like, nervous the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
You break off on the end, yeah, just a few tubs, maybe. A lot less stressful, but all good.
Yeah.
So, we are going to point her north, and about a 7-hour run to get home.
Yeah,
offload in the morning.
Get these fish cleaned up, get them down and iced, and relax for a while.
Yeah, how'd we do back there, man? Those are some beautiful fish.
Yeah, we did pretty good.
I think at least 7 nice ones.
Really good grade. I think we had one small fish, huh?
Yeah, actually two. Yep.
Two?
Yeah, that's like a 50 pounder right there.
Those are beautiful fish.
Yeah. Very nice, very, very nice.
We'll make some nice fillets, make some nice dinners.
Yeah.
One of the beautiful things about having split holds, one middle, two aft, two forward. You can see we're a little bit listy right now in relation to the horizon. and that's just because we've been slushing ice down into that one, and our outfold over here doesn't have any ice in it. Also, a pile of fish back there. But like I was saying, this is the beauty of split holds is that you can fill up your forward tank and turn back out. So yeah, pretty cool. Just want to share that real quick.
Alright guys, just a little bit of halibut cleanup. Get these guys cleaned, get them down the hold, get them iced. Got us on our way. We're heading north. Back to home. Fish. These ones are easy to clean, or rather quick to clean, because they stack up in the bin. What am I saying? Big fish are quick to clean, because I don't even know what I'm saying. Lost my train of thought. What I was getting at is that big fish are a lot faster to clean weight wise, just obviously because they're bigger. You're cleaning a 35 pound fish rather than a 15 to 20 pound fish. So what I'm doing here is gilling and gutting. Pull the gut sack out here, side, cut the blood line. And remove the gonads here. After that, I can take my ice cream scooper, scrape the bloodline out. So the reason I cut it is to make it a little more easy to scrape out the bloodline. There's a membrane over the top of it, so if you don't cut that, it kind of just like makes a saran wrap type layer over it. Pretty hard to scrape. Scrape out that bloodline, scoop it out from the gill, hold it like a bowl, and there's also a couple of sweet meats, we call them, on the spine here that you gotta be sure to scrape off. They spoil quickly, and that's done.